Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland. We have a knife review, and today we're going to talk about a very special knife for me personally, because it's actually going to be a limited production version of one of my favorite custom knives, and I'm talking about the Guy Poggetti Sanyo. Guy Poggetti is a little bit less known French knife maker, especially in the US, but a knife maker that I was following for quite some time now and was able to acquire this absolutely gorgeous Sanyo model from him. This is his most popular model that he has in his lineup. It's a very nice Japanese inspired front flipper. As you can see here, my custom model sports an Elmex blade in this nice black or dark stone wash and absolutely gorgeous wood scales. This is Tasmanian black wood and probably my favorite wood ever being put on a folding knife. Absolutely gorgeous. Sports a clip. Not all of his Sanyos have a clip. That was a request by me. As a liner lock, has some gorgeous carbon fiber liners underneath the wood and a carbon fiber backspacer. So this was the knife that the production version was modeled after. Not this particular knife, but this model. And the Sanyo is also named after a small Japanese town called Sanyo in the Niigata region of Japan, a town that was famous for building knives and swords and other sorts of crafts. So certainly a fitting name for this knife. And the knife maker has been making knives since 2012, is more or less self-taught, also does some Damascus in Seoul authorship. So certainly a very achieved knife maker here, Guy Poggetti. Also his logo is very nice. This is actually based off some Neanderthal wall paintings. As you can see, there's certainly some resemblance there, because Mr. Poggetti is also a trained artist, so painter and things like that he also has done, or maybe still does. So this is the knife that the production version was actually modeled after, and I have to say they really did a great job. This production version is brought to us through Riyadh, who is building the knives, and Editions G, as you can see here in the back, which is actually facilitating the connection and is selling these production folders. You have seen a review of an Editions G collaboration also on my channel. This is this one here. This is the Canif, which is another French knife maker collaboration. This is not made by Riyadh. This is made by some small shops in France, so even a little bit more hands-on collaboration. Absolutely gorgeous slip joint folder, and all of these Editions G models are actually limited to 300 pieces, and this one is number 41, talking about the Sanyo here. So here you get your certificate of authenticity, some info on the back. So really love what Editions G is doing. They really try to promote some French and European knife makers with these collaborations, make their work available to more people, because of course these custom knives are, for one, expensive, but also pretty hard to get your hands on, especially if you're in the US, because these are not readily available outside of Europe or even outside of France. So really love the effort that Editions G is putting in. He has done collaborations so far, so please check out his website and his Instagram. Everything will be linked below, as well as the Instagram of Mr. Guy Poggetti, which is certainly one of my favorite French knife makers. And you know, I have quite a collection of custom French makers at the moment, and also have experienced quite a bit. So that certainly is saying something if he's one of my favorite makers. But let's take a look at the knife itself. So this is the production Riyadh made Sanyo. And first off, let's take a look how it compares to the custom at the top right there. And you can see right off the bat, in terms of length and size, they certainly nailed it. So it's pretty much identical in terms of length, height, and overall design. The switch is a little bit less high, or just a bit less pronounced on the production version. We have a slightly smaller logo as well. Of course, the handle scales are different. Also, the integration of the screws is different. Here we have also titanium hardware. These are dome screws, nicely bronze anodized, and here we have the black and flat screws that integrate very well into the wood scales. Also, we have some scalloping on these contoured carbon fiber scales, so you can see there is some slight scalloping, so you have a raised line down the middle, even pronouncing the overall form of the Guy Bugatti Sanyo here by Editions G and Riot. We still have a liner lock like on the original Custom. So these are both titanium liner locks. We have a more pronounced cutout here. You can see on mine only the titanium liner is cut in, but not the scale itself, but it still facilitates a nice and easy disengagement of that liner lock. Here you have a more traditional cutout where you can even more easily disengage your blade there. Other than that, a thing that I also noticed in terms of differences is that the flipper tab has a little bit more height, and that the edge where it actually contacts, or the lockup face where it actually contacts the stop pin here, is slightly rounded on the production version, and you can see there is a little bit more of the blade exposed. Not quite sure why they did it just like that, but just something that I noticed. You can also see that the overall form factor also in the close position is very resembling of each other, really, really close. Another thing that's a bit of a difference is thickness. So if you take a look at the thickness of these knives, you can see that the carbon fiber scales are a bit thicker than the wooden ones. So this is certainly a thicker knife in the hand as well as in the pocket. And I believe part of that reason is because they actually integrated a reversible deep carry pocket clip, which is certainly quite a bit different from the custom clip we have here on the Sanyo. But that certainly gives you a bit more thickness that you need so you can slide in that pocket clip. So that's certainly a neat addition. If you're left or right-handed, this really is a fully ambidextrous knife. You can flip the clip, and of course it's a front flip, which is very easy to manipulate with your left or your right hand, and also disengaging the liner lock is absolutely no problem with your left hand. So that's really well done, and I think a well intended and executed addition for a production version, because here of course you can ask Mr. Bugatti if he is willing to build you a knife to put the clip on the other side. On the production version, with that execution, you actually have the possibility to swap the clip if you want to. And how they did it, it doesn't take away anything from the overall design. You don't have holes in the carbon fiber scales or anything, very neatly done there. Also, the pocket clip on the Sanyo here works very well, nice and deep carry. I probably would have gone for a non-skeletonized clip, but that's certainly personal preference. You have good clearance, nice lip, nothing too large, so it won't scratch up a lot of things. The edges are slightly sharp if you really bear down on them. It's not really sharp, but not super rounded, so you can see there are more or less 90 degree edges here. But in hand, the pocket clip doesn't provide any hotspot in a hammer grip or even in a saber grip, so they really have that integrated nicely with this angle that they have chosen here. So that's really well done as well, and I think a great addition for a production version. Also, another difference is you have standoffs in the back as well as a place to lace a lanyard around in comparison to the backspacer with integrated lanyard post right there. But other than that, I think these are most of the changes. Of course, materials are different. Carbon fiber M390 instead of Tasmanian Blackwood carbon fiber backspacer, and Elmex on the custom. I will just leave the custom here in the back to hang out, so you can see what this knife was actually based on. Jimping is different, a little bit more spaced out as well as on the custom here. But other than that, very, very close to the custom in overall design and especially size. Also, weight of these two knives is identical on my scale, which is also a pretty well achieved point. But let's take a look at the specs of this knife. Now we have done the comparison part. So on the Guy Bugatti Sanyo by Editions G and Riot, limited to 300 pieces, we have an overall length of 20 centimeters or 7.87 inches with a blade length of 8.7 centimeters or 3.4 inches. You of course have a slightly shorter cutting edge. As you can see here, you have this kind of 50-50 choil there. And also in terms of sharpening, the first little area here is not sharp, but that is actually not too bad of a thing, because this actually saved my thumb quite a bit when manipulating this knife, because it's that smooth. You will see that later on as well. But the cutting edge I measured here on this knife is at 8 centimeters, or about a 3-inch cutting edge with a little bit of longer overall blade in terms of reach. The blade stock is at 3 millimeter, the steel is M390, and you know Riyadh does an amazing job with how they treat their M390. Also, finishing is done very well, so we have a horizontal satin on the flat parts here with the nice Guy Pogedi logo, and then we have a vertical satin on the grinds as well as on the swatch. And of course, in terms of markings, they really have toned it down. That is something that Editions G really does well. Just put all the spotlight on the maker. You have the maker's mark on there, and then just pretty understated Editions G logo. And other than that, these are very, very nicely done. You only have a marking for your serial number. Here we have also the number 41. So these are actually matching pairs. And we also have the marking here on the inside of the titanium liners. This also is number 41. So certainly in terms of blade execution, nice high flat grind, very nicely sharpened. Just the beginning here is a bit of an issue. If you want to sharpen that out, you might get a little bit of a smile during sharpening, but overall, from this point right here, the sharpening is super well executed, extremely sharp. Not the thinnest knife behind the edge, so they still have some material back there, but because it's such a nice high flat ground blade, it actually cuts very, very well in my use. Also, the liners that we have here are nicely knocked down and chamfered, so no sharp corners anywhere on this handle. Very well executed overall fit and finish, like you would expect from Riyadh. You can also see that the fitting of these scales to the liners is just absolutely flawless. You can check out centering here. Action is also super smooth, perfectly centered here. And lock up nice and early, very solid, no blade play on this knife. And you can see it, of course, runs on a bearing system. I'm not quite sure if it's ceramic, but most Riyadh knives are actually ceramic. These are certainly captured bearings, and the action is very impressive, as you can see right here, free falling. And that, I mean, with the additional benefit of that little tiny part there that is not sharpened, because that's exactly where it lands on your finger right there. So it's actually a little safety feature maybe that they thought of. In terms of ergonomics, this very neutral handle actually lends itself to be a great knife in terms of doing some hard cuts into woods and things like that, a little bit of a bushcrafty thing. You can even choke up right there in this 50-50 choil, as you can see here. Very well done. You really can do some nice and detailed work just right up at your cutting media. So I really like that for sure. And also in a saber grip, very comfortable. Your thumb lands right here on this part. And because the swatch is not as pronounced as on the custom, it's actually even a little bit more comfortable to put your thumb right there, because this is actually a really pronounced swatch in comparison to the production version. Also, left-handed, very nice right there, same capacity to choke up. And let's take a look at the action. So we have seen super, super smooth, because you have a little bit of higher point of attack here on the pivot with your front flipper. It's actually also easy to do a slowly and controlled rollout, which is not a thing that you can do with all of your regular or lower profile front flippers. So this is certainly a great thing if you're considering using this knife in a more crowded area or around the office. So if you want to open it slowly and controlled, you actually can do that very easily with that larger front flipper portion. But of course, you can also flick it out no problem and have lots of fun with a great front flipper. What you can't do really is a reach around, because there is a lot of area to cover here, and I never use my front flippers that way, but that would be a little bit harder with the way they executed the front flipper here. But the detent is super nicely executed, very close to the custom. Custom maybe slight bit more crisp, but really, really close. You know that Riyadh can build a knife and can execute a great action, and they certainly have done that here. Very impressed with that. Also, the material that they use here, like the carbon fiber, is absolutely top shelf. You can see no real voids in there. It's full real carbon fiber, very nicely contoured. Overall, just super well done. No sharp edges or corners anywhere on this build. As I said, the only thing that's a little bit 90 degree-ish are the edges on the clip right there. But other than that, everything is very nicely touched by hand and made very smooth. And I really like the possibility to open the knife so slowly and controllably without any issue. So that's really a great thing that they have done with the way they executed that front flipper tab. Now let's do some other size comparisons that I like to do here on the channel. First up, we have the F95NL from Shirogorov, and then the Shirogorov Neon Zero. And you can see it's much, much closer to a Neon Zero size, pretty much identical to the Neon Zero, maybe a tiny bit shorter, but certainly quite a bit shorter than the F95NL right here. Then we have our benchmark EDC blades, which should certainly give you some good information about the size of this. If you haven't held a custom Sanyo, we have the Bug Out, full size Bug Out, and the Para 3. And you can see it's a little bit larger than the Bug Out, just a tiny, tiny bit, and certainly longer than a Para 3. Here we can also see a good comparison where you can see that the thickness here is a bit higher up. It's certainly thicker than a Para 3. It's actually almost 0.6 inches. So it's 1.5 centimeters in overall thickness. And that is certainly thicker than most knives you find around. Also, I haven't mentioned the weight of the knife. It's 105 grams or 3.7 ounces, identical to the custom in the back right there, but certainly nothing overly heavy, nothing that's overbearing, but certainly also nothing extremely lightweight, talking about a cutting edge of 3 inches. So certainly a medium weight, but nothing that should concern you or draw you back from buying this knife right here. Then I have some other front flipper comparisons. Also certainly a knife that some people are reminded of with seeing the Pogetti, and also that I included the custom in the video of, and that is certainly the Riyadh Bushido, which is a much smaller knife, also a bit a thick knife for its size, featuring some gorgeous burlap micarta, a 3D milled clip, also an M390 blade. This one is also a hand drop or horizontal satin finish all around, but this is also pretty hard to open and close slowly. That's very hard on this one. You really have to bear down on the jimping to do that. So that's nicely executed on the Pogetti. And you can also see that this is certainly a much more full EDC sized folder in comparison to the Bushido here. So the Bushido is much, much smaller. And you can also see that the overall curved nature of this Japanese design is very well executed here on the Pogetti Sanyo, very close to the custom, as you can see right here. So much, much closer in overall design language. You can also see that we have a higher flat grind in comparison to the custom there, and certainly more based on the Sanyo than the Bushido, which never was meant to be a direct copy of the Sanyo as far as we understand. But you can see much, much different, and I have to say I certainly prefer the Sanyo collaboration by Editions G, even though I certainly like the Riyadh own branded Bushido here, which is also a pretty nice small gentleman's folder. But if I had to choose, I probably would go with this one here. And this is certainly also an absolutely gorgeous knife that also was built with the permission of Mr. Pogetti. Some other comparisons I have for you are some other French customs or very well-known front flippers. Here I have the Remy Labial New Hardy, also in gorgeous carbon fiber, also one of my absolute favorite custom knife makers from France. And you can see that the Pogetti Sanyo is a bit larger than a Remy Labial New Hardy. I also think if you're considering buying a knife from Mr. Pogetti, this could be a great thing to actually handle a knife from him in a almost perfect copy in terms of dimensions, even though this is a bit thicker, everything else is very, very close to the custom. Here we have a 3.3 inch Shamwari for comparison, and you can see these two or these three are pretty much identical in overall length, but I think the Pogetti certainly has a much more pronounced element of design. I really like these Japanese inspired designs that the Pogetti is doing, but he also has some drop points and some other designs. I highly recommend to check out Mr. Pogetti's work. I think he has one of the best French knife making skills, and I'm really happy that Editions G actually collaborated with one of my favorite overall designers to bring us this gorgeous knife. And even though if you have a custom already, this could be a great user and carrying knife that you can still experience the design language of Mr. Pogetti without the risk of marring up your very hard to get custom. So price wise, we're talking here about 285 euros, ordering directly from Editions G. I think that's the only way how you actually can get this, but he also offers international shipping. He has a website in English and everything will be linked down below. So highly recommended by me, the production version of the custom Guy Pogetti Sanyo by Editions G and Riyadh. Absolute home run design, very well executed by these companies, and I would highly recommend to check this out and get it while you can, because as I said, these are limited knives to 300 pieces. This is number 41, and I believe from what I've heard, these are going quick. That's also why I wanted to put out this video as soon as possible. So check out this knife, check out Guy Pogetti and Editions G. All the links will be down below. I hope you liked the video. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.